So, you know, I saw the message, you know, that Jojo Diaz said, you know, hey, I would love to welcome you back into the ring, champ. Let's get it, LA. And then my reply was, I can't remember exactly what I said or wrote, but it's more like, you know, welcome me back. Like, you know, I've been here. Like, you know, I've been here for years. If anything, you know, I'm going to don't quote me again. I don't know if I said it, I'm saying it right, but I think I said something about it will be more of a, I shouldn't have done that, you know, like, you shouldn't have called me out, basically. So, you know, we'll see what happens. At the end of the day, people got to understand that, you know, there's nothing personal between me and him. He's a good guy, but, hey, if he's calling me out, you know, hey, get ready for the comeback, you know what I'm saying? Retaliation, and that's what it is. We're fighting.
I think he was one of the latest interviews I've done.
Oh, really?
Yeah, because I went, he had a parade.
Grand Marshall.
And I went there and I saw his manager. You tagged him on your post. I saw him and he was calling Leo Santa Cruz out.
Yeah,
now he's calling you out. You guys going at it on social media. So tell me, first of all, how is your health? How ready are you to come back to boxing without even, you know, fighting some names?
I've been good, you know what I'm saying? Obviously, I've been out for boxing for a while now. It's going to be 2 years since I last fought Leo Santa Cruz in 2018. I was scheduled to fight Tank Davis last year, February. You know, unfortunately, I got injured. But I'm good. I'm good. I got green-lighted, you know, to come back as early as late last year, I'm sorry. My doctor gave me the green light to come back and fight, but I said, you know what, I'm just going to take the full year, and I did. So my intentions were to come back this year in May as a doubleheader. We're thinking that, you know, I think Leo was going to fight Tank Davis, and I was going to fight in the undercard, you know, doubleheader. Perfect, you know, because that's a potential matchup, you know, in the future. Again, you know, I still have unfinished business with Tank Davis. Because of the fact that, you know, just fighting it never happened and they got promoted and a lot of people gave me shit for it, you know, so I owe it to the fans. And right now, you know, I just woke up with the news, like, you know, like Jojo Diaz calling me out. And like you said, like he called out Leo too, but I'm sure they realized that Leo's already fighting Tank. So they said, you know, hey, what's another big name, you know, for us? And, you know, thank God, you know, I'm still one of those big names. I fought many great fighters. I'm a four-time world champion. And it'll be a great fight, especially here in LA.
I remember that time, you know, it was like, yeah, so like excited to see that fight. Yeah. And at the end of the day, you know, it
That's
is what
crazy.
It is, but
we oversold the place, you know that? Right now it's called the Dignity Health Center, but before the StubHub Center, we oversold that place, meaning we had to add bleachers to the arena because people, you know, wanted to be at the fight. And a lot of celebrities are going to go, and, you know, fuck, man, I got so disappointed. But it is what it is, you know what I'm saying? Like, I couldn't do anything about it. Like, I could have fought, but, you know, with the risk of, you know, going blind. So, you know, there's no money in the world that you know, that I can take, you know, to do that. So I said, nah. I was like, I'll just wait.
Who was the biggest celebrity that was supposed to be in the fight?
Because I know it was, like, during some type of awards, during that same weekend, so a lot of rappers were gonna go. The Baby, I think, you know, he walked out with him. Like a lot of
McNeil, probably.
Yeah, a lot of rap artists. Okay, you know who I would like to fight? You know, I think any of those names. Obviously, Tank Davis is the bigger name right now, as well as Ryan Garcia, David Haney, all these young kids. They're the big names. And you gotta be real. You gotta call it how it is. You know, I made a name for myself in boxing, but these guys took it over to the other side, where like they're known all over. You know what I'm saying? Ryan Garcia, obviously, with the social media following that he has. But I think that for me, I'll fight anyone. Like I just said, I answered that question. But I think Tank Davis still needs a big name on his resume, so that's why he's looking for the Leo Santa Cruz. He's looking for the David Haney's, the Ryan Garcia, and eventually, you know, move up and weight and challenge like Mikey Garcia or any of these tough fighters. But, you know, he's got a lot of work. He's got a lot of work. He's got to be disciplined and only time will tell if that guy's gonna make it, because you know we all know that he's a party animal. It's not hidden. You know, we know that, and you know, we know that's gonna play a big factor if he doesn't take care of that. So we'll see. I'm a big fan of David Haney. I'm a big fan of David Haney. So let's see how he plays out also.
But you heard that he called out Mikey Garcia.
Yeah, and I don't see that wrong. You know what I'm saying? Like, all these young kids calling out veterans and top, you know, fighters, it's no disrespect. It's just that they're trying to make a name for themselves also, you know? And they're in a good position right now and in a position where they can do that. And it's good, because at the end of the day, that's what boxing needs, you know? We need big matchups like that. Because regardless of JoJo calling me out, I was intentionally looking for, you know, Mr. Al. I was going to call Al and tell him to get me the Gary Russell fight. Gary Russell fight would have been, you know, it will be good, you know? So if any of these fights don't happen, like JoJo, we can't make it happen for, you know, any reason, you know? Obviously, I have plan B, which is Gary Russell. If it's not Gary Russell, you know, there's other big names. But I got to come back with the big name. Got to come back with the bang. Oh, I want to come back with 30. Yeah, I can't do 26 no more. So
yeah,
30, okay. Or if there's a big name at 35, I'll take it as well.
You're still training with Robert, right?
I'm not.
Oh, you're not?
No. I'm with the new trainer. I know a lot of people give you shit for that, too. Like, man, you jump with trainers, like, you know, like crazy.
Who?
No, I'm not. I just made that decision not too long ago to go with another route. I'm now training with Manuel Robles. And the reason for that is nothing personal. Robert and myself, good, all bad. But it's just, you know, time consuming. I was driving a good hour and a half to his gym. And, you know, I just want comfort. You know, Manny Robles is 20 minutes away from my house. So I think it just works out better.
Another fight that was supposed to happen, it was Lomachenko Teofimo Lopez.
Yeah, it's not happening, right? I heard that they're postponing that. That sucks. I mean, but then again, correct me if I'm wrong, but I heard it was Loma that said that needed more time or wanted a tune-up fight. Is that true?
I haven't heard anything like that. The only thing I heard that is due to coronavirus, you know?
Obviously, yeah, it's postponed right now because of that. But then I heard also... Again, you know, don't take my word for it. But I heard that Lomo said that he might want a tune-up fight before the big Teo fight because of you know, the whole being inactive, you know, this whole time. So who knows? But I mean, at the end of the day, I want the fight to happen. It's a good fight, big fight. I think it's a 50-50 fight. I know a lot of people are jumping on Teo's bandwagon because he is the shit. He is the real deal right now, you know. Young kid, explosive. He has it all. But, you know, let's not forget that Loma is an out of this world, you know, fighter. A fighter that, you know, we haven't seen in many centuries because of his fighting style. He can adapt to any style, and he always does great. You know, what he did with Guillermo Diego Downs was just phenomenal. That's just, you know, amazing. So I wouldn't be surprised if he beats a Teo, but I'm also part of the Teo Pompilo Lopez bandwagon. I'm pulling for him. I'm going for him, and I hope he takes it because he's a good young kid.
Yeah, you know, it's surprising, like, how people actually counting out Lomachenko in this one, you know? Usually it's like vice versa, you know, you give it to the veteran.
Well, you know how it is. People get excited, you know. Remember by your last fight, your last man, how Teo did against that African fighter match. It was phenomenal, the way he just took him out with that left hook. You know, oh, no, it was that overhand right, I'm sorry. So, I mean, Teo right now is the deal.
Tell me, what would be the first fight that you would love to see after this lockdown?
Damn, if it can happen... I would love to see a Terrence Crawford against Errol Spence.
Yes.
Yeah, against Errol Spence.
If they
can make that fight happen, oh my God. And again, if Teo fights Loma, I mean, let's make it happen, man. As a fan, those are two great fights.
Yeah, Crawford and Errol going at it on Twitter, actually yesterday, 2 days back. So it's fresh, it's new. Of course, your fight. And... you know who else? David Benavidez called out Canelo.
Again, I don't see that wrong. I think he's in his all his rights right now. Benavidez is a monster. He is considered one of the best in his weight class right now. But I think the fight he needs to look for, it's the Caleb Plant. I think Caleb Plant against him will be just phenomenal, and I hope that one happens first, because at the end of the day, Benavidez is still growing, obviously, also as an athlete and as a professional boxer, and I think he's still learning. He's still in the learning process. Correct me if I'm wrong, but he's still like in his 20s, so he's a young puppy. He's still a young boy, you know.
Tyson Fury and Wilder 3.
I mean, make it happen. It'll be exciting. I got a lot of shit for it, obviously, because I was going for Wilder. I was one of the few, because a lot of people were like Tyson Fury, obviously, because of what he did, you know, in the first fight. He did box, you know, Deontay Wilder, but Wilder was always looking for that fight and that knockout. Eventually, he got the knockdown, almost had him out, but couldn't. But then for Tyson to come back the way he did and bully a Deontay Wilder was just, man, it was amazing. Like, damn, how did he do that? You know, and then eventually stopping him, it's crazy. So that third fight, I think, is just, we don't know what to expect. I don't know if Tyson Fury is going to come with the same plan, or is he going to try to box this time? And we don't know if Deontay Wilder is going to fully mentally ready to take on a defeat.
So tell me, how are you handling this lockdown, the quarantine?
I'm chill, man. I'm big chilling. I'm enjoying it. You know what I'm saying? Like, a lot of people, obviously, it plays in many ways. Like, you can take it as a stressful moment because you're not in your everyday, ordinary, you know, task. You know, you're not doing your normal, you know, routine. And obviously, within days, a couple of months, it gets you, you know, mentally. But I'm a big family guy. I've always been, you know, part of family guy. I'm always here with the wife, with the kids. But I just can't. I need it. We all need to get back to society. You know, we all need to get back to the real world. It's getting tired, I guess. It's getting boring. You know, and I hope it ends quick, sooner than later.
I know. I miss two things: it's going to the restaurants and boxing. There's no fights. There's nothing going on.
All these replays, right? So it's good you're doing all this. You know, this is what, you know, people need to see what we're doing, what's happening, what's in our minds and in our mental states, you know, because there's a lot of people that are going insane, you know, people that are going crazy, you know. At the end of the day, a lot of people are suffering with all this, you know, financially too. So it takes a hit on a lot of people, you know. All these big companies also losing a lot of money. So we'll see, you know, slowly but surely, I think, you know, the economy and the world is gonna, you know, it's gonna get better.
Amazing. Thank you so much for your time. I don't want to keep you here long. And, you know, have an amazing day.
Appreciate
that. Stay safe.
Thank you.
Wash your hands. And I hope to see you soon.
Yes. All right. Yes, I will. God bless
you. All right.
You.
Bye.
You take care, all right?